Our last restaurant comes to us from Daniel. This spot is run by a husband and wife team that's putting Chihuahuan cuisine on the map. This is Tacos Chiwas.
Tacos Chiwas is, you know, my wife and I's little brainchild. It was always a way for us to kind of represent who we are and where we grew up. And we're from Chihuahua, which is the reference to Chiwas. So the menu, you know, is very much things that we grew up eating. We have tripa, we have chile colorado, which is a red gordita or burrito. We have everything from carne asada. We have calabacitas as a taco. It's a vegetarian dish. It's a Mexican squash. You know, from a regionality standpoint, what happens is Chihuahua is a landlocked state, right? Very much like Arizona. So we don't have a lot of reference to like seafood. So we're very protein forward. The ambiance we're going for here is just homey. You know, you're coming to my house. The vibe is that anyone can eat here anytime. The back wall of peppers is basically our reverence to the chile colorado. It has a huge impact in the culinary scene for Chihuahua. Every year I drive to Chihuahua and bring 500 pounds of it back so that it's consistent for a full year's worth. The whole idea with doing a taqueria is how do I make the best of each individual thing, right? And the greatest compliment is like, this tastes like my grandma made it. And a lot of people who live in the United States who aren't able to leave and go back home, when they come here and they try something that specifically touches their, you know, heart, I'm telling you, like it's a wonderful feeling. There's nothing else can kind of make it better.
So Daniel, I know Armando and Nadia. How did you find this restaurant?
I'm always on the hunt for a good taco, and you know, thankfully I live in Arizona, so there's plenty of choices. But I found their original location, their old location in Phoenix, when I was working out there for a little while, and then they luckily opened one up pretty close to my house in Mesa, and started going there, and I fell in love with it back there, and it was just. It went even more often now that it's so close, and
so what's it like? What's the vibe there?
It's energetic. It's kind of you know, downtown Mesa's kind of on the upswing. I feel like a little bit, so there's a little more energy, a little more people.
Yeah.
The restaurant itself is kind of a cool neon sign in the back for tacos, and the menu's all kind of hand painted on the wall right on the side, and cool little patio. So
what do you like to eat? What do you recommend there?
I probably get every taco when I go there. And I have a few favorites, but I'll usually always get a barbacoa taco. That's my favorite. I mean,
oh my gosh. Sylvia's like, oh yes.
Yeah. I mean, it's just melt in your mouth, the barbacoa. That's just my favorite.
I've heard they use beef cheek for that.
Yeah, I was
super
about to
tender.
Say,
is that right? So
I have never had beef cheeks before. And you're right, it just melts in your mouth. And it's when you bite into it, it's like a flavor explosion.
Yeah.
And it was good. I love the barbacoa.
Well, beef cheeks are a delicacy, at least to me. So you had barbacoa, what
barbacoa, else? And then I'll usually get a carnitas and a pastor. And their pastor is a little different. I think it's more of like a Chihuahuan type. Uh-huh. But it's really good. It has that nice kind of that red color and a little acidity from the pineapple. And it's really delicious.
So, Sylvia, you're nodding. Tell me about your experience there.
Baby, let me tell you about that elote corn.
Isn't that good?
Oh, yeah. I went home and tried to make it, and it just didn't come out. But it was fantastic with the, you could taste a little hint of lime, and then you've got the mayonnaise, and then they charred the corn. So you, little pieces, you get a little charredness and up.
So that caramelizes the sugars in the corn a little bit, so it makes it more complex. Texture-wise, it's better,
And it wasn't chewy. It was still like popping in your mouth, I thought. Yeah. And it was good. And I had the barbacoa, and I had the pastor quesadilla.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
That was all right. Look, when I go out, I'm going out to eat.
I know, they're a little small, but it makes it so you can try a lot more flavors.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Sylvia is an Olympic diner. I'm loving this. I'm loving this.
Okay. Yeah.
Mark, what'd you have?
I had the lengua. Mm-hmm. Usually, if you do it wrong, tongue, which is what that is really chewy. This stuff was exactly that melt in your mouth. It's like gone. Where'd it go? It's in there.
It's low and slow. You've got to cook it for a long time.
Really,
low tempo.
Yeah, really good. And I tried one of the ones that they put their name on, which is Tacos Chiwas. It has ham cubes, and then probably the barbacoa meat is the beef that's in there. Mm-hmm. Wow, that was really good. And then the calabacitas, that's the squash.
Yeah, squash taco.
Oh, man, those were really, really good. Then I had a quesadilla. I thought I would try it, but I, again, already said, you know, don't like too much salt, and that was pretty salty.
Danny, you have anything else? Dessert or anything?
Yeah, I had a really good, it was like a tres leches carrot cake. And it was a special, I think, that day.
I missed that one.
I'm going to have to grab that one. And it was, yeah, I mean, super, like, kind of carrot cake, but then had that nice kind of, I think it's the condensed milk.
Yeah, or the sweetened condensed milk.
Dulce de leche kind of is in, that was just really good. They have a really great, I think they make like purees for their drinks and their margaritas.
Yes,
and
they do.
They have like a tahine, instead of like a salt rim,
they'll do
like a tahine rim. So it kind of has the lime and a little spice and salt. So there's always something, and with their specials and everything, I feel like I'm always kind of going back and getting something new each time.
Mark, you had some drinks too, right?
I had they have a variety of soda pop. I don't know which way you want to say that, but anyway, soda or pop. They have the jarritos, which are the different flavors from Mexico, and I have usually guava and tamarind because they go really well with the tacos, especially those tortillas, those corn tortillas, man, they are super fresh. And when you've got them with the sweetness of the jarritos, it's really actually, you could just eat that.
I had the soda too. I had the pineapple.
It was really good, and it really went well.
Never had that. It was refreshing. I thoroughly enjoyed it. I mean, I was really impressed. I love the vibe too.
Oh, you did?
But because it was, the patio was right there with the garage door open. And I know you...
I have to laugh because they opened it while I was there. So I got in there before and it was really quiet. And they opened it and the train came by and the police sirens and helicopters and an airplane went over. And then a Winnebago pulling a boat. And I was like, there's nothing left.
Daniel, your place, any pro tips, takeaway?
Kind of like the pizzas, get one of every taco. Just explore, try something you haven't.
Sylvia?
I would say explore the menu and then just the area. It's such a cute area and it fits in perfectly with that area in Mesa. I enjoyed it.
Mark, pro tips?
Sit deeper into the restaurant. Away from the opening garage
door. If you want to try Tacos Chiwas, they're located off of Country Club and Main Street in Mesa. An average meal will cost $15 and they do not take reservations. They have two other locations as well, in Phoenix and in Chandler.